show. Really? Yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private.
This is the NFL on EA Sports as we welcome you to MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This is the scene just before we came on air. This New York crowd fired up by the arrival of their G-men as they burst from the locker room. They're ready to go as the Giants get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Jones now on first and 10. Oh, nearly a disaster there on the check down. Jones, but they'll get it back.
Intended for Saquon Barkley.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Here's second and 10. To throw again, Jones. They'll set up the screen to Barkley, and they're able to get this one across the 35. A gain of 13. It's a first down.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass-rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
25 yards that time.
Giants, first down. First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
The first carry for the former Nittany Lion. This is Saquon Barkley. And he'll snag about 5 yards down to the 32.
Brought down by Levante David.
Working with second and 5 now.
Brings up second and 5 at the 30.
Jones with a handoff to Barkley. And only able to get 2 here. Stopped at the 30.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he's brought down, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards. From the 8, they've got it first and goal. Operating from the gun, Jones. Flushed out right. And he'll get this down inside the 5 to the 4 before he's out of bounds. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there at second down.
I think we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
Second and goal from inside the 5. A first carry for the Clemson man, Wayne Gallman. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Giants take it right down and score on the opening drive. That's just a solid, methodical drive to start this game.
And how about how it culminated? Doing exactly what they wanted to do, getting the ball downfield, and then running it into the end zone. I'm just telling you, partner, when you run it in rather than throw it in, that hurts a defense psychologically a heck of a lot more.
Set to kick off.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there.
First and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
Brady and the Buccaneers here, first and 10
at their own 26.
Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man.
So a nice job to break the one tackle, but not much daylight after that as he's brought down.
Down at the 31.
Big Leonard Williams there on the stop.
Second and 6.
Second down, it's Jones. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers.
The ball carrier.
Ronald Jones, 69 yards. And the Buccaneers are an extra point away from tying up this football game.
Kick is good.
And he's got it up and through.
Ties the game at 7. Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. That last drive, it was a good mix. Run, pass, run, pass. Defense on their toes.
And what really helps out in a big way is when you're doing the run-pass mix and everything's working, that means that they're guessing wrong every time on defense. They think you're going to pass when you run and vice versa. I would continue that, and when they finally draw a bead on you, maybe you mix it up a little bit, a little play action and throw the ball.
And will they maintain that balance? Time to find out. Behind the chain, second and 13. Throwing, Jones. He completes it to Tate. And he'll get this up past the 25 before he's out of bounds. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
And Ingram hauls it in. And all the way in, touchdown, New York. Evan Ingram, 73 yards. And the Giants have taken the lead. Seeing some pretty good offense here in this first quarter.
It's been a wild start to this quarter, as you noted. And now with that lead that we're seeing, can they retaliate? I get the sense this one's going to go back and forth all game long.
And that probably won't be the last long touchdown that we see in this one. It's up and good, and it's 14-7 now here in the first quarter.
14, Buccaneers 7.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. And this will make it into the end zone. Ogunbowale elects to not bring it out.
At their own 25-yard line.
And this will probably be the last play of the quarter. Here's the first carry for LeSean McCoy. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. Throwing on second and three, Brady. He'll set up the screen to McCoy. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass, looked like it was coming together, looked like there was an opening. Still, ended up with a solid game.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. From the gun, it's Brady. His first running back, McCoy. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot him at the 44.
It's a pickup of six.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice, safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space. It turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And tackled down after a gain of three. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on third down.
It's a gain of three. Brings up third and inches.
Brady going to try and throw on third down. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the Michigan man, Jabril Peppers. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. Well, look, we're watching a quarterback here that's obviously been around for a long time. That's a throw he wishes he had back.
He certainly does, but as you well know, this is a guy that's used to taking a few chances, used to fitting it into tight windows. These are throws that he's made before. Didn't happen to get it.
He's got it at the 15. Touchdown, Giants. Evan Ingram. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Giants strike quickly here for 6 points. So simple math here in the first half. They've had three drives offensively, and they have scored every time, and they've got the lead.
Well, whenever we talk about adjustments, we usually talk about an offense making adjustments, right? This is all about the defense. They've got to figure out some way, somehow, to slow them down. Do they blitz a little bit more? Do they play more zone coverage? Right now, they don't know where to go because they're hitting them in every direction.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. A tale of two extremes already in this game. A touchdown pass on their opening drive followed by an interception last time out.
Now, it sounds like things balance out, right? What's that mythological thing that we do? If you have a candy bar, have a diet soda with it, it balances it out. And we know that's not really true, right? Because the interception, that's...
And that's caught inside the 30. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Justin Watson, 72 yards. And the Bucs get the quick strike touchdown.
Well, if the plan is to come in here and go toe-to-toe with these guys, it certainly does not hurt if you hit them with a big shot along the way, too.
That's got to give them some confidence. And the other thing right now, it quiets this crowd, at least for the time being.
Yeah, that is what is called the intended consequence of their actions.
Here's Gay now to add the extra point. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now.
Giants 21, Buccaneers 14. Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. On the return, here's Corey Coleman. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21.
First and 10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time, see if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
Number 20.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. That's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense, not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder coming up here at halftime. We'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. Now this pass into the hands of Saquon Barkley. And they work this well upfield across the 45. The extra effort after the catch makes it good for a gain of 26 and also a first down. Here's Jones on first down. Open target here, Darius Slayton. Well, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. He's got his man. This is Tate. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards.
At the Bucks 32-yard line.
From the gun, Jones finds his tight end, Ingram. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Evan Ingram on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the Giants are able to grow their lead.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
And this one will not be handled. It's into the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But there's also something to challenging your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
Here's a second and 2 now from the 33. Shotgun now for Brady. They're looking for Godwin, but it's intercepted. Picked off by James Bradbury. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line.
You're trailing. You're trying to get points late in half. I absolutely understand that. But remember, it's all about the ball. And without the ball, you can't get those points. They just turned it over.
Now you got to be careful, because that deficit can get a little bigger on the other side with that good field position they just took over with. This is the NFL on EA Sports as we welcome you to MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This is the scene just before we came on air. This New York crowd fired up by the arrival of their G-men as they burst from the locker room. They're ready to go as the Giants get set to match up with the San Francisco 49ers. The kicker, Graham Gano, set to put his foot into this one. And off we go from MetLife Stadium. He'll have a first down past the 40. And brought down across the 50 to the 49-yard line. A big hitter there. A first down gain of 26 yards. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 49-yard line. And he'll lose yardage here. Back at the 47. Big Leonard Williams, the one who came in and got him.
When Leonard Williams was picked in the 2015 NFL draft, I compared him to Merlin Olsen. And I got a lot of grief about it. Did you just see that play there? Did you see how he made that move and made that tackle? That was Merlin Olsen-esque.
Yeah, I just perked up when you said Merlin Olsen.
Yeah, a lot of people said, hey, that's too much, too far, and maybe it is early, but I think this guy has a chance of fulfilling that.
15 yards on the play, first down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. They'll run for the first time with Jerick McKinnon. And some room to roam now. Touchdown, 49ers. Jerick McKinnon, 38 yards. And the Niners have taken the early lead. On paper coming in, you'd say that these guys are the better team by far, and they sort of showed their superiority there on the opening drive.
Yeah, they came in the heavy favorite in this game, and even though they're on the road, they just still got just wiped it away, didn't they? They just said to everyone, we're the better team. We just showed it to you on this opening drive, and we expect to do it all game long.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Saquon Barkley. He'll have a first down past the 40 and brought down across the 50 to the 49-yard line. A big hitter there, a first down gain of 26 yards.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
They were trying to get it there to Sterling Shepard. That'll bring up second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Now left side on the swing pass. 9 yards, and that leaves him just short. So it'll be third and less than a yard.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen, where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Give them 3 yards and a fresh set of downs. A first down carry for Barkley, fighting his way down to about the 35-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
11 yards there, first down. So a solid run by Saquon Barkley and another first and 10 here. And now here's a carry heading left. And they take him down, losing yardage back at the 27.
That whole thing was thrown off track thanks to the defense of Fred Warner. Really nice play. That loss of three, a rare stumble on a promising drive. Here's second and 13. Eluding the pressure right. And Ingram's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Evan Ingram, 27 yards. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And it's no good. He misses the extra point, and this remains a 7-6 game.
Graham Gano set to kick off.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. And they'll watch this one fall in the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
25-yard line.
Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. On the ground, it's Mostert to start the drive. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
With the score.
I know we can't hear what's going on in that huddle right now, but I'll guarantee you at least one offensive lineman is saying, my bad, we simply couldn't move them off the line of scrimmage. We've got to do a better job trying to root those guys out of there.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and eight at the 27-yard line. Here's a throw right side, taken in by his tight end. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. A gain of 28 yards there, and give him a first down.
First down, San Francisco.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now. First and 10 at the 45-yard line. Garoppolo going to give to Mostert. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
That was a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco.
San Francisco.
Raheem Mostert, 38 yards. And the 49ers add on to their lead.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit. But for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
At their own 25.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They'll start out on the ground as Saquon Barkley. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
Barkley, the ball carrier.
Well, sometimes as a running back, you've got to be able to improvise when the hole's not where you expect it to be. But in this case, there wasn't any improvisation that he could do that was going to work. Kind of like if you're trying to be a comedian on open mic night at the improv and you run into a tough crowd.
A loss of one. It's now third and 9.
Jones to throw on third down, escaping the pressure right. He's going to let one fly for Tate, and this will be caught at the 30. A big play there for the Giants. 44 yards. So the big play has him all the way down to the 30 now for first and 10. Now Jones. That is caught right at the 10-yard line. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Golden Tate, 30 yards. And the Giants are a two-point conversion away from tying this football game. And this time he gets it to go as it is up and good.
Makes the score, Niners 14.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kicks away. And this will make it into the end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line. So the same result, had he opted for the touchback.
25-yard line.
Ready to get this next drive started. The New York offense at the line. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. Two drives, two touchdowns.
Yeah, can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
It'll be a gain of 10 to start the drive out by a few inches. That'll be a first down. And he's got a first down there after a gain of about 12 as the clock will stop right now for the two-minute warning. He'll get a dozen there, and it's a first down, 49ers.
And the 49er first.
We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Jonathan Coachman. He's in Orlando, and he'll have our EA Sports halftime report. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, second and right at a yard.
He was brought down by game.
Here's Mostert. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42.
Raheem Mostert.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
First down, 49ers.
Here we go.
Garoppolo on first down. That's caught by his running back, Raheem Mostert. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down. 4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up 2nd and 6. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. 12 yards there and a first down.
A gain of 12. And the 49er first down.
Garoppolo now, first down throw. A battle for it, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Xavier McKinney. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Intercepted.
So from the 17 now, here's a 1st and 10.
At their own 17-yard line.
Now Jones throwing on 1st down. Flush to his right. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up 2nd down. 2nd and 10.
Brings up 2nd and 10.
Throwing again. Jones. Incomplete.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They forced incompletions on 1st and 2nd down, bring up 3rd and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
On 3rd down, Barkley. And able to use a stiff arm for a little bit of leverage before he's taken down. A pretty good game. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this first half. And how about this one now? In their own territory, a gutsy call. They're going to go for this on 4th and 1 yard. And they'll run for it with Barkley. Barkley a 1st down and more. And now look at him go. And all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Saquon Barkley, 73 yards. And the Giants have taken the lead. And with that carry, he's already over 100 yards here in the first half.
And, partner, you know exactly what he's saying to his teammates right now, right? Especially to the play caller.
Give me the ball.
Again and again and again. It's not that heavy, sir. I'll take it.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Niners take over 1st and 10 at their own 25.
Ready to get this next drive started. The New York offense at the line. Inside of a minute left in the half. Does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. From the gun, it's Garoppolo. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. They spot it on the midfield stripe. So it is a 60-yard attempt here. And oh, off the crossbar, no good. A sensational effort from that distance, but rejected by the bar. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Second half ready to get rolling. The Giants with a lead, and they are set to receive this kick. And that going to hit in the end zone as we restart things here in the second half with a touchback. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies. Try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. Jones fakes the give to Barkley. Finding Sterling Shepard for his first catch. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. On first down, Barkley. They're going to snuff this play out behind the line. We have not seen that much today. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
A loss of two brings up second and 12.
On second and 12, Jones is going to fire one deep. It's caught inside the 25. Touchdown, Giants! Evan Engram, two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead.
The Giants.
In order to lead in a game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. And this one incomplete. So they went for the two, they don't get it.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
First and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
Ready to get this next drive started. The New York offense at the line. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. But sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. On second down, Mostert. And to the 36-yard line. Taken down there after getting 8 yards. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. They'll stay on the ground with Mostert. And he is finally out of bounds, but he gets all the way down right around the 20.
A gain of 40.
Trailing here in the third, and that run might just be the spark that this offense needs.
And don't you just get the sense that he's going around, not just in the huddle, but looking over at the bench and saying, ball, give me the ball. Let me carry this thing home.
And not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20.
That's a really nice play. We're able to stack that one up. But they get back in the huddle. He's got to tell his guys up front, great job. They kept people off of him, allowed him to run free, and make the hit on the runner.
Filled the gap nicely, kept him to just a one-yard gain. On second and 9, Garoppolo. And they'll get this on the screen to Mostert. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. A good job defensively to hold that to 4 yards, and now it's third down. They missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down. Working from the gun, Garoppolo finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal. First and goal, and they got to be thinking a chance to get right back into this football game. And across the chalk, into the end zone, it's a 49er touchdown. Raheem Mostert, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the 49ers have cut it back within a score. And this is back to a five-point game.
Makes the score Giants 26. 40.
Here is Wisnowski to boot it away following the touchdown. And they will watch this one land in the end zone. That'll be a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
Brings up 2nd and 3.
Off play action. Jones gets this out to Saquon Barkley. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. It's a pickup of 17 and a first down.
One of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy.
There goes Sterling Shepard. And he will take it on in for a Giant touchdown. Sterling Shepard, 51 yards. And the Giants add on to their lead. That's a pretty quick response to that last touchdown drive. And it seemed like they maybe given up momentum. Not so fast.
No, not at all, because they ended up pushing the lead up once again. And you're exactly right. Thought momentum might have been shifting. Instead, they grabbed old Mo, didn't let him get to the opposite sideline.
And he returns this to the 22.
G. James on the return. The Niners take over 1st and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
Ready to get this next drive started, the New York offense at the line. I guess they have to feel a little gratified to at least get on the board last time, but still work to do.
No doubt about it. I wonder now if they're going to try to increase the urgency a little bit, maybe pump up the pace, maybe go 2 minute. Who knows? Let's see what they decide to do.
And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's 2nd down. From MetLife Stadium. Here's a 2nd and 10. A shotgun snap for Garoppolo. And right back to Kittle. This time he's got it. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Back now here at MetLife Stadium. It's 49er football, but some ground to cover. They find themselves behind as we hit the 4th and final quarter. Scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Mostert. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
He was brought down by Blake Martinez.
From the 45 on 2nd down, Garoppolo. And that's incomplete. And this one incomplete, threw it down at the feet of his receiver. After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. They'll try and run here with Mostert. And he won't be close to a 1st down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. The defense stiffens to force 4th down following that 1st down gain of 8.
Now 4th down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on 4th down. They're going for it. They'll go for it. It's Garoppolo. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And he's got the 1st down, yardage before being taken down at midfield.
The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now a nice play defensively on first down as this is knocked away and incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. And his throw is incomplete. He was looking for Trent Taylor there, and it's third down.
So many times when we talk about coverage, we're just talking about a defender running with a receiver, but a big part of it is understanding where the football is, finding it. In this case, when it arrived.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37.
They don't know my name. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I'll get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say fall and you let go. But I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yo, look at me, at the asylum. Was a fate or mistake, cause the time ain't up. Yet the parts of my mind don't get much love. If you want in my head, come and call me up. You look like a twisted Robin Hood. Yeah, you take from the rich and the poor and us. Wearing diamond shoes where you walk your pugs. In a town you create where there ain't no love.
Where do I go?
This is the NFL on EA Sports as we welcome you to MetLife Stadium here in East Rutherford, New Jersey. This the scene just before we came on air. This New York crowd fired up by the arrival of their G-men as they burst from the locker room. They're ready to go as the Giants get set to match up with the Baltimore Ravens. Two teams have met in Super Bowl 35 down in Tampa. The Ravens and Giants are underway. This is Saquon Barkley. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Out of the shotgun, they run with Barkley. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is. And really, a lot of the time, they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance. They're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. So in Raven territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 41. Flushed out right.
On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And the return goes up to his own 17-yard line.
A young quarterback, Charles, rolling to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
And they're going to stop it right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
Second and 10.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. They'll fake the give to Ingram. Now Jackson. Catch is made by Marquise Brown. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds.
A gain of 15. First down, Ravens.
On first and 10, it's Jackson. He's got his man. It's Andrews. And he gets this one to midfield before he's brought down.
The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down.
Well, I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
Mark Ingram, the ball carrier.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
A gain of 5.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off. A pretty decent game.
From the 45 on second down, Jackson. This is caught inside the 15. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. It's a big play there for Baltimore. And even 40 yards. And this is caught. Touchdown, Baltimore. Willie Snead there to make the grab. And the Ravens have taken the early lead.
And the QB rating right now, sky high. 4 for 4 on that opening drive, and it ends with a touchdown pass.
Yeah, I don't know quite how to figure it out. I think I need my friends from MIT to come in and help me. I think 158.3 is the number one.
Yep, that's the
right,
high
that's the highest you can get. That's where he is. He'd like to continue on that pace.
Take over first and 10 at their own.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to emulate, and of course they'd like to forget the ending, the interception, but they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, it does them no good to go back and say, well, you know, we had a good one going. Finish things off. That's the only way you can get it done.
Ravens 7, Giants nothing.
They'll run on first down. Barkley. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and 2.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8. So a solid run by Saquon Barkley, and another first and 10 here. It's complete to Golden Tate. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Jones with a handoff to Barkley. He's brought down at the 34. Call it a gain of 4.
The ball carrier.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And some space here. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 and mark him at the 5. They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
The 5-yard line.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 10-yard line. Patrick, a full five-yard loss that time. It's going to make second down pretty tough.
Second and goal.
Moved back to the 10. They'll try on second and goal here. Barkley, toss play left. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. 1:58 left to play till we hit halftime. Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And Ingram's got it. Touchdown, Giants. Evan Ingram there to make the grab. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Bouncing back nicely from that bad opening drive where he threw the interception. Drive number two leads him right down the field and into the end zone.
So obviously his confidence was never lost, and that's a big thing to see. Great quality to have. You absolutely must maintain that as a quarterback. I have to think that they're probably still on the script that they prepared for this game. Just the second drive, they've worked on these plays all week in practice. Put them to good use on that one.
And the decision to come out of the end zone is going to cost him 5 yards as he's taken down right at the 20.
Their own 20-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Last time they were out here, they had the benefit of good field position, led to a touchdown. This time, they're going to have to work for it.
They are, but with that last drive, that culminated
and the giant rush gets home as down he goes. Kyler Fackrell. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop it. To try again after the sack. Jackson.
Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
And he's able to get this down deep on the Giants' side of the field. A big play there on the catch and run. And even 70 yards.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18.
And he is into the end zone for a Baltimore touchdown. Lamar Jackson with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Ravens have taken the lead. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game.
Score, Ravens 14, Giants 7.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this will not be fielded. It's a touchback and comes out to the 25.
25-yard line.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's something that's safe. It's something that's been done many times before. A lot of people say it's not even worth trying, but I'm running a draw. I'm running a screen. I'm seeing if something pops. And if it does, that can alter my strategy and potentially get me some points. And if it doesn't work, well, then you just run the clock down and go to the locker room.
He's going to loft one deep up. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Operating from the gun, Jones. He completes it to Tate, and inside the 20 before he's brought down. Now a signal and a timeout call, as it comes with 9 seconds to go in this first half of play.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That is caught at the 7. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. Another catch for him there. This one good for 11. First down. Not time enough for a play and then a timeout, you wouldn't think. So with 4 seconds left, they're going for it. And now we'll get a late timeout as it comes in the waning moments of quarter number 2. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up first and goal. The final shot before break. Jones. And that's incomplete. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon.
The Ravens ready to receive it. And they've got the lead as well as we resume play in the second half. And the third quarter will start with a touchback as that one lands in the end zone. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ball game.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Out of the gun, they give to Ingram. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
Would you say this offense is locked in right now?
They're having no trouble on this drive. What is it, three plays, three first downs?
Yeah, you talk about on the march. They keep this up, they'll get to that end zone real fast.
An opening there on that first down run as he gets this forward for about 8 or 9. That looks to be 8 officially, so second and 2.
Brings up second and 2 at the 24-yard line.
On second down now, it's Ingram. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9.
Mark Ingram, the ball carrier.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
A 4-yard
and the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. From the gun, it's a run for Ingram. And not a whole lot there. He does get a couple, taking it from the 5 down to the 3. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I open.
And that'll be taken in by Andrews for a Ravens touchdown.
Touchdown.
A 3-yard touchdown pass as the Ravens push further out in front.
That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game, even more so than a 2-touchdown lead, right? Because you have taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
They'll try and get this run game going. This is Barkley. They find some open field here. The 40, the 30, 10, and all the way in. Touchdown, New York. Saquon Barkley. 75 yards. And the Giants have got it back to a one-score game. And he pushed it right. It's no good.
No good. Graham Gano set to.
So with a missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off.
DeAnthony Thomas on the return. The Ravens take over first and 10 at their own 35-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. The ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Nice way to start the drive. A gain of 12 and a first down.
And the Raven first down.
Ingram again, a first down carry. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Run blitz there defensively, something we might see more of here in the fourth quarter.
I think we'll see a lot of it, and the difference between that and a pass blitz, you're just trying to get to the quarterback. You're trying to scheme someone open who will get to the QB and make sure he gets on the ground. In a run blitz, you're actually trying to cover up gaps, trying to cover up holes so they can't run the football.
On second and 12, Jackson eluding the pressure right. He'll try and run it. The quick feet by Jackson. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. They run. It's Mark Ingram. And he's going to get this inside the 30. 10 more there and another first down.
I think we're seeing the effect that runs like that are starting to have on this game. They're a little bit slower, that front seven, reacting to the football, almost like body blows in boxing, slowing them down, and they're really starting to take over in this game.
He's got it to Ingram, complete.
Jackson.
6 yards on the pickup, and it'll bring up a second down.
Another nice pickup through the air, and I think a lot of people might expect him to run the ball in this situation, Brandon, but with this lead, they're electing to throw the football. Swings, slants, quick outs, things that they consider safe.
To throw again on second down. Jackson firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. 9 yards the pickup there, and it's a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. A 10th carry here for Mark Ingram, and he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Trailing in the fourth this close of a game, that's a penalty you just can't afford.
It's an absolute killer, and it's one that drives coaches and teammates insane.
After the penalty, it's Ingram. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Ravens will add on to their lead. That almost looked too easy, and I think thanks goes to the offensive line for making it look easy.
Yeah, I agree with you totally on that one. I'm not sure how much everyone understands the preparations that go into a game for an offensive line, because there's a reason that running backs and quarterbacks give them big gifts at the end of a season after a big year. The consistency and the continuity it takes to know each other and execute their blocks is pretty impressive.
Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll drop it off with Saquon Barkley. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here, and that'll make this a second and 13. 2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, Jones. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth.
They went with the dive look that time on defense, just flooded the field with defensive backs, blanketed everyone, took away all the passing angles, thus the incompletion.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. This is Ingram on first and 10. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. After the loss to start out, here's second and 11.
It's a loss of a yard.
And despite the late lead, Jackson to throw. Fine time to his left. All that gets him is just a yard, and now it's third down.
So many times we talk about having good eye discipline when you're playing defense, making sure your eyes are in the proper place on a given play. Looks like that discipline came to the front there, didn't it? They were able to hold him for a short gain when he took off running.
And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 40 seconds remaining in this fourth quarter. With things looking pretty good on the scoreboard, they're going to keep the offense out there and go for it here on fourth. From the gun, Jackson. But they're going to wrap him up as he'll go down well short of a first. The Ravens go for it but come up empty. And the Giants are going to get the football back. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Jones now on first and 10. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Marlon Humphrey.
Come on, bring it, baby, bring it.
This spot in the fourth quarter with that deficit, had to throw the football. Unfortunately, there's the risk of big turnover.
And you know you're going to be throwing against nickel, dime, all sorts of exotic defenses, but you have to do it anyway. Ordinarily, you might want to run the football a little bit, try and get them out of it. But as you noted, this time of the game, this point on the clock, had to throw it.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. So now with 6 seconds remaining, we get a timeout on the field.
It's a gain of 10. First down,
back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Oh, good move. He's going to run again. And he's going to get this past the 50 and into Giant territory. So the final seconds tick away in this Baltimore victory. And they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you...
It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. Here's a scene a short time ago. The Ravens introduced to this sellout crowd, and through a sea of pyrotechnics, out they came from the tunnel. We're set to go as the Ravens get ready to match up with the New York Giants.
Graham Gano set to kick off.
Two teams have met in Super Bowl 35 down in Tampa. The Ravens and Giants are underway.
Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Over first and 10 at their own 19-yard line.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20.
First down and more for Jackson. And he's going to get this to the 40-yard line. Beating him there with his legs. 21 yards. First down. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Mark Ingram. And he'll push this forward only to about the 42-yard line.
Mark Ingram, the ball.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
42-yard line.
Throwing on second and 8. Jackson. Incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. He may try and run for this. That one will go for 9 yards and a first down on the keeper.
Well, if you're going to run the read option, typically, you've got to keep an eye on the defensive end.
And what does that mean? What are you looking for with a defensive end?
Well, you want to play off of what he does. If he collapses inside towards the running back, then you pull it and take it yourself outside in. If he stays outside, you go ahead and leave it with the running back. In this case, pulled it and got good yardage himself.
From midfield now, here's Jackson. It's brought in here by Willie Snead. And he's going to get this one down to the edge of the red zone. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Looking left sideline, incomplete. Marquise Brown was the intended target, and that'll bring up second down. After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20. Stepping up, he's going to keep it. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Ravens touchdown. Taking it in from the 20. And the Ravens take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive.
Let's make no bones about it. On paper, they're the better team. They're at home. That's a strong opening drive.
And just think how many times we've seen this type of a matchup. Just what you said, better team at home should steamroll them. And we've seen it go the other way. Sometimes, though, they buy into it and understand we are the better team. Let's go out and prove it right now.
And the Ravens lead at 7-0.
Makes the score Ravens 7, Giants nothing. Justin Tucker to kick off for Baltimore.
Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. A first carry for the former Nittany Lion. This is Saquon Barkley.
And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least two first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Now it's second and nine. Off the play fake. Jones. That's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards there. First down.
We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
On second down, here's Barkley. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and two is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
Jones throwing complete here to Tate. 7 yards, the pickup there.
Complete. I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
And at the 7-yard line, the catch is made. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Score, Ravens 7, Giants nothing.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back. They'll try and run for it with Barkley. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. It's a gain of 1 yard, and it'll set up second and goal.
It's a gain of 1 yard.
Second and goal from inside the 5.
At the 4-yard line.
Off the option, that's complete. No gain that time on the completion, and it'll be third down. If you're going to pass down here, you better get that in the end zone.
I agree with you totally, and as we both know, the field's already condensed. There's just not a lot of space, so you've got to create some by getting some people downfield into the end zone. If you want to throw it short, you've got to have some movement, some room in order to do that. That one didn't work.
Third and goal at the 4-yard line. No gain on the play that time, so a big stop, and it's going to leave him with a 4th and goal. Let's think here. You're still just in the second quarter. You're taking the 3 points?
I am taking the 3 points, and I'm just relying on my defense here. Show me I have a little confidence in them, and let the offense know, nice drive. Come back next time. We'll go get 6 then, but for now, we'll take the 3.
Jones throwing on 4th down. Tate bringing it in for the giant touchdown.
And Tate, touchdown.
4 yards on the touchdown grab. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. Big 4th down conversion for the score and the defense. That is a tough pill to swallow.
It is good.
Big time for them. How about them just deciding to go for it on 4th down? And, forget the field goal, because that looked like an easy 3 points. Yeah, you might have had a defensive breakdown in there, but they pressed the issue and found a way to get it into the end zone. Give them big credit for that.
And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
Take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going.
After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offense's sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too.
Had to sit over there for a little while, didn't they? You know, they were eager, amped up to get back on the field after just scoring, hoping to get the ball back quickly. That didn't happen, so I'd say come out, just kind of get started again. You know, it doesn't have to be anything dramatic. Just get moving, get loose again, and see if they can get it downfield.
12 yards there on a first down.
Well, partner, for a few years there, we thought this read option play was going to take over the whole NFL. It seemed like everyone was using it. But it has been scaled back considerably in the last few seasons, mainly because people worried about their quarterbacks getting hit. But when you call it at the right time and you use it properly, you see the type of gains you can get. A nice chunk of yardage there.
And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack.
He's taken out of
the... Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
Coming up at halftime in a little less than 2 minutes, we'll send you to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman is standing by. He'll have highlights and analysis of this first half. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. Give him 14 on that one and a first down. A couple of first downs on the drive already, as they'll go from the 47 now on first down. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. Hollywood Brown, the intended receiver, and it's second down.
As a defensive back, you have some weapons at your disposal that we don't often talk about, and you can read the receiver's eyes, you can read his hands, and you know that the arrival of the ball is imminent. And that allows you to make a play on it and oftentimes knock it away.
Yeah, this Giants defense getting off the ball quickly. They stop him behind the line again. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. They'll indeed go for it with Jackson. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 32. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Well, that's a drive killer right there. Not a really competent throw either. This one was kind of up for grabs, and it's going to come down the hands of the wrong team.
Good starting field position for the New York Giants here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep two eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting two hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit. Even for those big tight ends, who you would think could absorb that contact.
And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done. Better than a 30-yard gain as we wind down towards 30 seconds left in the quarter. Jones on first down. This is Shepard on the catch. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts, as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime.
Here's a first and 10 at the 14-yard line.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. And, of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. Operating from the gun, Jones will get this out to Barkley, complete. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three.
The Giants going to burn their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. And Barkley will try to punch it in. And he takes it into the end zone for a Giant TD. Saquon Barkley, as the first half is winding down, and the Giants have taken the lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment and you have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards.
10-10 at their own 21-yard line.
The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. Likely time for just one final play, and then it'll be off to the locker room to talk about how they can erase this deficit.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people look at it and go, well, maybe you take a shot here. Maybe you get some momentum going into the half. What's the flip side of that? You do something crazy, quarterback gets hit, ball comes free, and now you're down an even bigger margin. Go ahead and take this one. Go to the locker room, start over.
And they're just going to run it here up the middle. And he'll work this back to right around the line of scrimmage and surrender there. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half. And he'll be upended here after a pickup of three, getting it out to the 25. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Okay, coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome in downtown New Orleans. This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the New York Giants. The kicker, Graham Gano, set to put his foot into this one. And we are underway from the Superdome. And they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin at the 25. On first down, Breeze. And it's hauled in by Jared Cook. The 45. Good work after the catch. Going to net him 23 and a first.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
And good job of just fighting through one tackle there to pick up about three. Second down coming up.
28-yard line. A 3-yard pickup brings up second and 7.
From just shy of midfield, Breeze. And his throw here is incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Working from the gun, it's Breeze. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up 4th down.
Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
And that's caught by Smith. He gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 4th down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward.
Now a 1st and 10 at the 11.
Breeze now on 1st down. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So they will accept the penalty and move forward. Penalty, it's Kamara. And he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the 6. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's 2nd down. 2nd and goal from the 6 this time.
2nd and goal at the 6-yard line.
Yard touchdown pass, and the Saints have taken the early lead. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Lutz good on the extra point, and that makes the score 7-0.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Giants take over 1st and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
Jones and the Giants now with a 1st and 10 at their 25-yard line. He'll throw from the gun. Finds his tight end Ingram. The 20, 10, touchdown, Giants. Evan Ingram. 75 yards. And the Giants are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of? The key is calling it in the right situation, knowing when it exists to go to it. They did exactly that. They've got to feel really good about what they did in advance of this game.
Just looking down at the sideline now, their defense is like, man, can you have strung that out just a few plays? Give us a break. Back out there.
Hey, man, give that water break and get on out there and play.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense.
And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting.
Trying to get it to Thomas, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Blake Martinez, and he will return this one to the 30-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You gonna let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge.
A nice gain of 21 yards. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to battle his way down right around the 2-yard line. It's a good pickup of 7 yards, and now they're looking at second and goal. Another try for Barkley.
A nice run here early on. It doesn't take a great play call to realize you want to establish a guy his caliber who runs like this early, because they'll pay dividends as the game progresses.
It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal.
Here's Barkley. And he is in. Touchdown, Giants. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Giants have taken the lead.
But they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times, that's a passing play.
And the kicker, this has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although, I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Taken about 7 yards deep.
The Saints take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. Breeze a quick throw out to Thomas. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Well, as a lineman, they are trained. You've got to stay close to home. If you're more than a yard downfield, they're going to toss that flag, and they did there. On second down, here's Breeze. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And he will be out of bounds here on what will turn out to be the final play of this first quarter. Through one quarter, 14-7, our score. Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Brings up second and 12 at the 38-yard line.
Going quickly here to Thomas.
Breeze pass.
That throw good for only a couple. It brings up third down.
A gain of 2 makes it third down and 10.
Now Breeze on third down. Cook. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The Saints first down there on a gain of 11. So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Back to the ground, it's Kamara. He'll be taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Another scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Throw out wide, complete to Sanders. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10. From the gun on third down, Breeze. And this one complete to Smith. And the tackle going to be made at the 41 as they stop him a few yards short of the first. They do get 9, but it leads to fourth down.
Down and 1.
This offense converted once on fourth down earlier. Now they're out there again to try once more. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis of this first half of action. Breeze to throw for it on 4. Looking long for Thomas. Got him in. It's Thomas. It's a touchdown for New Orleans. Michael Thomas with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Saints are within an extra point of tying this thing up. Lutz with the extra point. And we've got a tie game here in a back-and-forth first half. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away.
Fair catch made at the 25-yard line. The Giants take over first.
The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tummy.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense get the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Giants strike quickly here for 6 points. It's up and good, and that'll make the score 21-14.
Giants 21, Saints 14.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
From the 27, Breeze. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. Third and long now after the sack of Breeze, and the Saints up against it here. Off the play fake to Kamara. It's Breeze. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. Picked up by James Bradbury. Get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line.
Oh, and that's a nice job defensively to get a piece of the football. He's going to pop it into the air, and then it's the tip drill. And good concentration by him to react to it and pull in the interception.
They'll set up the screen to Barkley. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. A nice little screen. They get 6 on first down.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. This will be caught inside the 10. And he will take it all in for a Giant touchdown. Evan Engram on his way to a monster game. 3 first half touchdowns. And the Giants are able to grow their lead. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14.
Giants 28. Saints.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. Fields it in the middle of the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they
can. And a big loss here as he's taken down.
The Giants going to go ahead and use the first of their timeouts, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half.
Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long.
Almost had it.
Already with one interception, just missing his second there. Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Looking again for Thomas, this time complete. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. Likely time for one final play here in the half, so they will go for it on fourth down. A final shot before half for Breeze. And they're going to try the screen. It's complete. And he's not able to get away. He is stopped well short of a first down. So we have come to halftime in what's already a 2-touchdown game. As we send you to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, so the halftime break behind us, and we are back underway with the third quarter of action. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
This is Tate. Touchdown, Giants. Golden Tate, 47 yards. And the Giants are able to add on to their lead.
Okay, we need to double check here with Marvin because he keeps all of our good stats. But what I've got is 5 drives, 5 touchdowns, and they've got a nice healthy lead.
After the first drive, we thought things might be clicking. They're really clicking at this point. They're clicking about as much as they can click.
And right,
I just
now,
said click a lot.
Yes, you did, but that's okay because the guy who's coordinating the defense, trying to slow them down.
Good luck.
He's going to have hair that looks like mine very soon. Not much of it.
First down 10 at their own 24-yard line.
Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger. But no time for discouragement. Just got to get back to it, right? Put your shoulder against the boulder and start pushing. And try and get back to where you were to start the half.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up 2nd.
From the 27, Breeze. And the giant rush gets home as down he goes. Dexter Lawrence. It'll go as a loss of about 8 as he gets in there to drop him. 3rd and long now after the sack of Breeze, and the Saints up against it here. And that is incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on 3rd down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a 1st down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get...
Now they're going to fake it from deep in their own territory.
Oh, but this is going to backfire as it's intercepted. Picked off around the 37. That interception...
So we just ran in the spot. And now we spin the block around just like the hell on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Come like a bat of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like I'm finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best, if it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess, you ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dust on you, like cheetah, run up down, I'm air in the scene. Not just like Vegeta, Prince, and I'm an heir to the seat.
I mean, for real. Test the driver's saw so I don't even grab the wheel. That's a lot on my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, because I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this loose thing, the fresh, but ain't half the man as well. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around just like the hands on the clock.
Just like the hands on the clock, I go back to bat when I'm doing numbers. All the mad that I'm driving the bus, so they threw me under. Heard they mad, they don't want to bust, so they boo each other. Think that they're the winning team, go losing, then they choose another. And that's okay, cause I'm competing with me, not you. I live with blessings like I can't stop sneezing, not you.
I hate to break a boy, me and myself top two. I blow away the competition like a bowl of hot soup. And there's no catch, I go and get the bag and I'm not bringing it back. I'm like a down QB, I put the pain in the past. And if you ever had a problem, promise I didn't ask. So it's 444 in the car, my dash. I shake a pic, told them all, you went first, you last. Little boy, that's facts, I'ma grow that cash to my money. You know what, let me stop.
Freaky, I heard a flare gun, I'm ready to race. No, I don't fear none, I'm stuck in my ways. They say I'm the chosen one, to see it in my face. Get this one and I'm holding on, I can't be replaced. I just take a sip when it's Brit. We on check for the win. Celebrate the win again. Celebrate the win again. Take a sip when it's Brit. We on check for the win. Celebrate the win again. Celebrate the win again. Yeah, the sun can't touch me. Got a brand new visor, yeah. Your friend's smart, but my butt's wiser, yeah. Get the job done like the equalizer. And I'ma grab another drink, cause tonight I'ma die like Michael Phelps. Hey, diving in this pool, I don't know what we have. I'm just telling you the truth. I heard a flare gun, I'm ready to race. No, I don't fear none, I'm stuck in my ways. They say I'm the chosen one, to see it in my face. Get this one and I'm holding on, I can't be replaced. I just take a sip when it's Brit. We on check for the win. Celebrate the win again. Celebrate the win again. Take a sip when it's Brit. We on check. She's in the moment, energy up, my body burning. And my stomach keep up turning, stop moving, I can't control it. All my last breath and I can't hold it, you gotta give it all I got. This for the ones that think I'm joking, yeah. This for real, lightweight bust off half a path. Yeah, I'm sweating, baby, must be all them happy meals. I don't know how happy feels, but damn, I'm trying to find out. She say I got sex appeal, I think it's cause I work out. Got a gun, I'm ready to race. No, I don't fear none, I'm stuck in my ways. They say I'm the chosen one, to see it in my face. Get this one and I'm holding on, I can't be replaced. I just take a sip when it's Brit. We on check for the win. Celebrate the win again. Celebrate the win again. Take a sip when it's Brit. We on check for the win. Celebrate the win again. Celebrate.
Yo, who told us we ain't gonna win, man? Really? He's a bozo. Bozo.
Yeah, we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gon' jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gon' pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the. Five, two, three on the business. Whole team got wins in the world.